So what's RAID 1 reliability if we do replace failed disks as soon as possible? We have the situation that both disks are okay for this amount of time. Then a disk fails, and then we have only one okay disk for the meantime to repair for one disk. So this is how long does it take us to replace the disk. After that, both disks are okay again, and then we again have this long until the next failure. So what's the meantime to data loss for RAID 1 with two disks? The question really is, how many times can we have this until we encounter the period when a single disk has failed, and during the time it takes to replace it, another disk fails? Well, it's equal to the length of this interval. This is how long we survive with both disks working, times how many times can we get this until we encounter a repair period where the second disk fails during it. So the question is really, what's the probability of the second disk failing during the time to repair one disk? Now, normally, to calculate this probability, we would have to compute the distribution for this function and then see what's the probability for this distribution being under MTTR1 and so on. But when the time to repair is a lot smaller than the time to failure of a single disk, then we can approximate this probability of the second disk failing during the MTTR for the first disk simply as the MTTR divided by the MTTF. So for example, if the MTTR is, let's say, a single day and MTTF is 100 days, then the probability of the second failure during the repair period is simply the length of the repair period divided by the period that we expect the disk to survive. So for example, if the time to repair is, for example, 1 day, and the time to failure is, let's say, 100 days, then we can expect that there is a 1 in 100 chance of a disk failing during the 1 day. So now, how many times can we repair the disk before we encounter one of these? Well, the number of times we can try this until we encounter a failure is going to be 1 over this probability. So what we finally get is this. The mean time to data loss is MTTF of a single disk squared divided by 2 times the mean time to repair for one disk. How long does it take us to replace the disk and copy the data on it so that now we have a fully functional RAID 1 array? And as a reminder, this is how long do we get a working array with both disks functional, and this is how many times do we do a repair until we can expect that the second disk that is covering us during the repair is going to fail on us. Note that because the MTTF is much larger than the MTTR, this is measured in years usually. This hopefully is hours or days. It's just how long does it take us to replace the disk. This factor here is very, very large. And now we get many, many times the MTTF of a single disk over 2. This factor is way larger than 2, which means that the time to data loss with a RAID 1 array with only 2 disks is way higher than the time to data loss for a single disk, which means that RAID 1 is dramatically improving reliability.